Thank you. Good afternoon, family, friends, faculty, school board, and fellow graduates. I'd like to welcome you to our 2017 graduation ceremony. When you find out that you'll be speaking in front of a couple, now almost about 600 people, just 3 days before, the nerves set in. Although I'm honored to stand before you all today, I should admit that I am no public speaker. I wouldn't even say that I have a way with words. But a wise woman reminded me that God had already gone before me, and he would not let me fail at this. I want to leave you with this, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. That is found in Jeremiah 29:11. We left our mark on THS, now it's our turn to leave our mark on the world. Once again, congratulations class of 2017, my brothers and my sisters. And welcome everyone.
Good afternoon. Today is a day about heroes. Graduates, your first heroes were your parents. They made you safe. They took care of all of your needs. Parents, your greatest heroes have been your children. You fought to open doors for them that you could only dream about. And when they were bold enough and had no fear and walked through those doors, and rose to success, they became your heroes. Once your babies left your home, they came over here to us. We started trying to mold their lives. Guys, you became our heroes. We began to mold you and shape you into the young women and men that we wanted you to be. And nothing tickled us better than to see you do that. I'm sure some of us teachers became your heroes. But we all today are each other's heroes. Families, you've done your part. This has been a family thing. It takes a whole village to do this. Ms. Barbara, please. Must have been cold air in my
classmates. Without all of you, this would not be possible. I'm Heather Roberts, the salutatorian of the class of 2017. I welcome all of you, because without everyone here, the journey would not have been possible. The journey which started way back in 2004. As an avid reader, I will describe this journey as a trilogy. At first, the book in the series, Elementary. Just like the first book in the series, we got to know the characters, lay foundations, introduced people that would play tremendous roles in our lives, formed cliques, and left an ending that required a sequel. The Elementary book was a time that seemed so difficult. Learning to read, write, add, subtract, multiply, divide, and the introduction of standardized testing. Although it seemed difficult, I'm sure we would all try Noel's English class for Miss Sally's PE in recess. Our elementary teachers did a tremendous job in preparing us for the second leg of our journey, middle school. Middle school, just like any other second book, was not as good as the first and a little awkward, but just good enough to read a third if one came out. Just like a second novel, new characters were introduced, new problems, the reformation of cliques, and a new twist, Mr. Parnell, which I'm sure Alex can tell you most about, considering he spent most of middle school with me. Middle school was scary at first. Back to the bottom of the totem pole. Not only were we bottom feeders, but we also got introduced to AR points, which were terrible for most of us, and I'm sure for most of our parents. But middle school also gave us something else, a sense of freedom, as we broke away from Tuckerman and traveled north to Swifton, away from what we had grown to know for the previous 5 years. Life began to change over the next 3 years. Boys became less gross and more cute, and schoolwork became harder and less likely to be done on time. Like most second books, with the addition of new characters meant that there would be some that we would lose before this book was done. And the ending of this book would set up for the final book of our series, High School. High School, like most good third books, the ending was clear in the first few chapters. As eighth graders, we now had an end in sight, class of 2017. This book had it all. New beginnings with the arrival of Mr. Fallen, comic relief with Mr. Doyle, kings and queens of prom, and inspiration with the thought of 2017, but also tragedy with the loss of one of our classmates, Isaac Odell Williams. Along the way, we all got new names, like freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and now seniors. Most of us got new vehicles, new girlfriends, boyfriends, but we all got new responsibilities because we were growing up. Accountability became the new word. We were all now being held accountable for our actions and grades, but it made us into responsible young adults, and for that, we are very thankful. I can't say enough about the special people we have met along the way. These people have pushed us, comforted us, cried with us, rejoiced with us throughout the years. And now that May 7th is upon us, and in a few short moments, this third and final book of our series will come to an end. We will walk across the stage, receive our diplomas, and walk out of those doors all to our own separate ways. Although the books we have all written together are coming to an end, it will be time for each of us to write our own individual book. Of that each of you will write a long and fruitful novel filled with success and triumph, worth 28 AR points, and not just another level to read. Thank you.
As each of us sit on this stage, we all have the same product, a high school diploma, and we are all to be commended for that product. But while our product may be the same, the process of beginning here has been very different. For some of us, the process was easy. For others, the process was anything but easy. Along the way, our class has endured life-altering events. We have lost a classmate, and we have watched others lose parents, siblings, and family members. The adversity we had faced, many people would call life. However, through all the adversity, we chose to continue the process, continue to face our fears, continue to climb the hurdles, and continue toward the product, our high school diploma. It is the process that created all our memories. Memories of winning the game no one expected you to. Memories of bus rides that resulted in widespread sickness. Numerous accidents on or around school campus. The memories of that nameless student prank calling 911. The test that we passed when we know we should not have. The countless stories from Mr. Doyle and life lessons from Mr. Richardson. The process is what we need. And while Mr. Hundley is a great motivational speaker, there is also wisdom to be found in another motivational speaker, Dr. Seuss. While our process of high school may be over, there is great wisdom in the children's book, Oh, the Places You Will Go. We have finished the process, and now we must go. Some of us will go on to college, some of us will go on to work, some of us will go to the farm, but we are all going somewhere. There are so many people to thank that have helped us reach this place. Our parents, teachers, and friends. We could never be sitting on the stage without your help. I leave you with the words of Dr. Seuss. And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along, you'll start happening too. Oh, the places you'll go. You'll be on your way up, you'll see great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. And you will will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed.
When we were in kindergarten, following our dreams was always stressed to us, regardless if it was to be an astronaut or a billionaire. Over time, our aspirations have shifted to more rational desires. Members of our class have dreams that range from being an engineer to a lawyer to just graduating high school with their sanity. Our journey to reaching our dreams have taken us down different paths throughout high school, whether we chose to take all AP courses or take classes just to get by. Every path taken has led us to where we are today, graduation. To achieve our dreams would be viewed as a success. Dreams aren't achieved overnight, though. In our case, a large portion of our path has included high school. B.B. King said, "The beautiful thing about learning is that no one can take it away from you." Everybody we have come in contact with during our time at Tuckerman High School has equipped us in some way to succeed in life. Whether it was teaching us that being wrong is okay, or that problems have many possible solutions. The lessons we have learned during this short period of time have given us guidance on this part of our path to accomplish our dreams. Take what you've learned during your time here and use it on your way to success. Something I have personally learned is that people are going to tell you success is not possible. It is just part of life, but it is possible. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." To my classmates, if you believe that your dream is worth achieving, the future is yours to have. To succeed in achieving your goals, you must know that you can do it, regardless of what anybody tells you. Your dreams are worth reaching, and you are capable of reaching them if you work for them. Do not let the people who are attempting to keep you back discourage you from reaching your goals that you've worked so long for. Use their negativity and constantly push yourself to reach your goals and succeed. I know every single one of you is capable of doing anything you put your mind to. Whether you want to go into the armed forces, be a dentist, be a farmer, or be a nurse, those dreams are worth reaching, and you can get there. The persons next to you will not travel the same path to reach their dreams, but we will all succeed in the end. Your path to success is unique to you. Some people may reach their dreams in 2 months, while it might take others 5 years. Travel your path, enjoy life, and never let someone tell you that it has to be done a certain way. Walt Disney said, "All of our dreams can come true." Yes, there will be bumps in the road on the way, but they will only make success that much sweeter. During those hard times, do not lose sight of what you're trying to achieve. I know every one of us at one point thought that making it to graduation would be the hardest thing to do, but look where we are now, sitting on this stage, looking at the rest of our lives. As you leave here today to begin your path to achievement, never forget that no one else's footsteps lead exactly to where you are going. Follow your passion, stay true to yourself, and never follow someone else's path, unless you're lost in the woods. Class of 2017, always know that you are capable of doing anything and your dreams are worth reaching. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Before I introduce the Board of Education, I'm going to take this opportunity to make a few remarks to the class of 2017. Seniors, I just want to thank you personally for all the contributions and achievements that you've made in our district. In some way, we will always remember each of you. You've been a very enjoyable class. I'm very proud of you personally. I know your teachers. Staff are also proud of me. And all the pride that we feel is only surpassed by the pride that is felt in the audience of your parents, families, and friends. And probably a little sense of relief too. So I say that having a graduate also. But seniors, will you join me at this time and just the seniors and give a round of applause to your family, parents, and friends. As I call out our school board members, please hold your applause until I finished with all of the members. Ms. Sandra Province, please stand. Ms. Ada Person, Ms. Tammy Clausen, Mr. Randy Wagner, Mr. Brian King, Mr. Phil Zuber, and Mr. Dennis Miller.
As principal of Tuckerman High School, I also want to welcome you to the 2017 high school graduation. We're here to honor these graduates who have fulfilled the requirements established by the Arkansas Department of Education and Tuckerman High School. A great amount of preparation has been given to our class of 2017 by THS, and these seniors have been prepared. Now it's their choice on how they will use this in their future. Many of our seniors will choose to further their education. Some have already chosen to join the armed forces, to serve in our militaries, while others will jump directly into the workforce. Parents, as Mr. Shannon said, we've really appreciated your cooperation with us to help us in this preparation of your child for their graduation. Seniors, you have many memories. These memories should be cherished. Always hold a special place in your heart for THS. We ask that you continue to share your successes with us. Whatever path you choose, choose one that will bring you happiness and self-fulfillment. During the awards assembly this past Wednesday, 28 students, which was 67% of the class, was offered 120 scholarships and financial awards worth a total value of $1,652,770. Very proud of them for that. Now with the presentation of the diplomas, I will announce the scholarships accepted by the senior class. Evan Keith Hubbard. Evan has accepted the following scholarships: the Newport Rotary Club, Arkansas Steel Associates, Pepsi Cola, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, the Arkansas Academic Challenge, UCA Academic, for a total of $52,000. Caitlin Elizabeth Platt. Caitlin has accepted the following scholarships: the Tuckerman Alumni Association, Arkansas Steel Associates, Newport Rotary Club, Cindy French Memorial, Morgan Gilbert, Pepsi Cola, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, Arkansas Governors, Line Athletic, and Line Honors Day, for a total of $193,870. Haley Madison Roberts. Haley has accepted the following scholarships: the Tuckerman Alumni Association, the Cindy French Memorial, Newport Rotary Club, Newport Kiwanis Club, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, the Arkansas Academic Challenge, and the A-State Pride, worth a total of $44,180. Cody Austin Taylor. Cody has accepted the following scholarships: the Newport Rotary Club, Pearl Ramsey, Caruthersville Firefighter Memorial, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, A-State Band, Arkansas Promise, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge, for a total value of $31,050. Emma Caitlin Drennan. Emma has accepted the following scholarships: the Newport Rotary Club, Post Foods, Medallion Foods, Arkansas Academic Challenge, for a total value of $14,700. Kelsey Elizabeth Walls. Kelsey has accepted the following scholarships: the Unity Health and the Arkansas Academic Challenge, worth $13,250. Marissa Danielle Britt. Challenge, for a total value of $14,250. Sierra Kinley Clark. Sierra has accepted the following scholarships: the Medallion Foods, and the alternate of Thelma McCartney for a total value of $2,000. Sarah Leanne Cooper. Sarah has accepted the following scholarships, the Medallion Foods, the Alta Vee and Thelma McCartney, for a total value of $2,000. Alexis Jade Kaylin Fitzpatrick. Alexis has accepted the Newport Rotary Club Scholarship worth $250. Andrew Flowers. Andrew has accepted the following scholarships, the Arkansas Steel Associates, Newport Rotary Club, Unity Health, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, UALR EIT Scholarship, the Arkansas Academic Challenge, UALR Chancellor's Leadership, for a total value of $40,600. Dakota Lee Fortune. Alex Gates. Dawson Andrew Gibson. Dawson has accepted the following scholarships, the Arkansas Steel Associates, worth $250. Billy Jacob Good. Billy has accepted the following scholarships, the Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, AmeriCorps, Lyon Academic Grant, Lyon Promise of Excellence, Arkansas Academic Challenge, Lyon College Apple, Lyon Honors Day, for a total of $150,000. Madison Shelby Hawkins. Madison has accepted the following scholarships, the Newport Rotary Club, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, Arkansas Academic Challenge, for a total value of $15,750. Jacob Chad Hockaday. Jacob has accepted the Buck and Jean Wagner Memorial Scholarship worth $525. Tashara Quinn Hughes. Tashara has accepted the following scholarships, the Cindy Friends Memorial, Newport Rotary Club, Jackson County Junior Auxiliary, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, Arkansas Academic Challenge, worth a total value of $16,550. Austin Wayman Jones. Graydon Jones. Zachary Wade Jones. Earl. William Lane Keller. Lane has accepted the following scholarships: the Auburn Grain Delta Soy, ASU Newport Incentive, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge worth $16,100. Andrew Dwayne Lancaster. Andy has accepted the following scholarships: the Arkansas Academic Challenge and the Montgomery GI Bill for a total value of $56,200. Andrew Alec MacArthur. Alec has accepted the following scholarships: Auburn Grain Delta Soy, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, Medallion Foods, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $15,050. Sarah Marie McClellan. Sarah has accepted the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $13,000. Andrew Wade Moore. Hannah Brooke Pitts. Hannah has accepted the Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, the A-State Band, Arkansas Promise, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $28,550. Joshua Michael Riley. Josh has accepted the following scholarships: the Arkansas Steel Associates, Medallion Foods, UALR ASAP, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total of $17,750. Noah Brayden Riley. Noah has accepted the following scholarships: the Iberia Bank, Cindy French Memorial, Arkansas Steel Associates, Trails to Tuckerman Student of the Year, Buck and Jean Wagner Memorial, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $17,025. Kenneth Ridden. Zane Michael Sadler. Zane has accepted the following scholarships: the Arkansas Academic Challenge and the Montgomery GI Bill worth $64,000. Amy Lorraine Shields. Samuel Allen Tennyson. Sam has accepted the following scholarships: the Newport Rotary Club, Auburn Delta Soy, Medallion Foods, Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, Farmers Supply Association, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $17,800. Kaylee Thomas Sykes. Kaylee has accepted the following scholarships: the Medallion Foods, the Alton E. and Thelma McCartney, ASU Newport Incentive, and the Arkansas Academic Challenge for a total value of $18,800. Selena Martina Thompson. Selena has accepted the Alton E. and Thelma McCartney and the Medallion Foods scholarships worth $2,000. Garrett Ryan Tubbs. Garrett has accepted the Arkansas Academic Challenge and the Montgomery GI Deal for a total value of $57,200. Mary Frances Wilkerson. $250. Anna Grace Ray. Students were eligible to receive or have accepted the Arkansas Academic Challenge Scholarship with a total award to the graduates of $314,000. The total amount of all scholarships accepted for the class of 2017 is $930,250. Mr. Shannon, I present to you the class of 2017.
Would you move your tassels, please?